Hello friends, in this video we'll see the most important interview questions that can be asked when you apply for mechanical design engineer post. So let us see. First question, what is a stress? So how will you define it? So it is defined as the internal resisting force developed in a body due to external applied force per unit cross-sectional area of that body. So in this way you will define the stress. Next, what are the various steps of machine design process? So this is asked by many interviewers. So let us see what are the steps. So here first step is the recognition of need. So in recognition of need comes what is the purpose or need of that product. Then second one is a mechanism. We need to design the number of mechanism for that particular product. Third one is the analysis of forces. We have to check the forces acting on that product when it is kept under application. It may be tensile forces or compressive forces. Fourth, material selection. This is the very important process. So here we have to select the suitable material with minimum possible cost. Then next one is the modification in design. If possible, we have to do the small changes in design in order to save the product cost and time. Next one is the detailed drawings and bill of material. So after that, we will prepare the detailed drawings, that is the 2D drawings and bill of material to produce that product. Next, third question. What is the difference between the first and third angle projection? This is also very important. So in first angle projection, the object is assumed to be placed in the first quadrant. While in third angle projection, the object is assumed to be placed in third quadrant. In first angle projection, object is placed between the plane of projection and the observer, while in case of third angle projection, the plane of projection is in between observer and the object. Now, in our India, we use the first angle projection method as per the recommendation by ISI, while the countries other than USA will also follow the first angle projection. USA is following the third angle projection method. Fourth, what is a sectional view? Why are sectional views used in a drawing? Now, sectional views are nothing but they are meant to see and understand the internal invisible details of an object. Means to know the interior construction of that particular object, we use the sectional views. Now in this case, if the object is cut by vertical plane, we will see its internal invisible details in the front view. And if we cut the object by horizontal plane, we will see the internal invisible details in a top view. So it will help in the right manufacturing as well as repair and servicing of the object. So this is the purpose of a sectional view in a drawings. Fifth, why the drawing is called the language of engineers? Because the drawing helps in conveying one's ideas in an easy, convenient and speedily manner. It also makes the study simple as it uses the international standards, conventions and symbols. That makes the drawing reading easy. Sixth, what are the standard sizes of drawing sheet according to ISI? So standard sheets that are available are A0, A1, A2, A3, A4, A5. A0 size is 1189 by 841. A1 size is 841 by 594. A2 size is 594 by 420. A3 size is 420 by 297. A4 size is 297 by 210. And A5 size is 210 by 148. So these are the standard drawing sheets that are available. This is also a very important question. So from these drawing sheets, A3 and A4 size drawing sheets are mostly used in industries. Next question, seventh, what is the projection isometric and detailed view? So projection view represent a three-dimensional object in a two-dimension while looking from one side. So basically, front view, top view, side view are nothing but the projection view of a three-dimensional object. What is the isometric view? So isometric view will represent a 3D object. Isometric view is nothing but a 3D object into a 2D in an engineering drawing. What is the detailed view? This is also very important in drawing. It represents the larger view of any section of engineering drawing. If the some sections are complex, so they are shown by a larger view. That is nothing but the detailed view in a drawing. Eighth question, what is the symbol of the first and third angle projection? So here are the symbols for the first and the third angle projections. You need to remember these symbols. What is the least count for vernier scale, micrometer and a normal scale? So for vernier caliper, if it is a digital, the least count means minimum possible distance a instrument can measure. So it will be 0.01 mm for vernier caliper when it is digital. For manual vernier caliper, the least count is 0.02 mm. And for micrometer, the least count is 0.01 mm. For normal scale, we all know that the least count is 1 mm. Tenth, what is the factor of safety and how it is calculated? So factor of safety will describe the load carrying capacity of a system beyond the expected or actual load. So in other words, factor of safety represent how much stronger the system is compared to intended load. So factor of safety is calculated considering the design load maximum value. Value of factor of safety will always be greater than 1. Next, 11th, what is the difference between the axis and the center line? So axis is nothing but it is associated with the circular shaft or hole. Then we say it is an axis. Center line, it is associated with a shape other than circular, like rectangle, triangle. These shapes are there, then we say it as a center line. 12th, why are the projection of objects not drawn in a second and fourth angle projection? So the reason is that front view and top view will overlap each other, thus there will be no clarity and it will be create only a confusion. Hence we are not using second and fourth angle of projection. So this is the first part of this video. Please also watch the second part of this video. Thank you for watching.